Well, hello and welcome to the latest edition of Business Matters. And this has been filmed on a momentous day, for it's just a day that we've heard that the application to join UEFA has been successful and Gibraltar becomes the 54th member. So a bit of a football theme today. It may be at first sight, of course, that football has little to do with business, but of course, that's just part of the story. More football, more interest in Gibraltar generally, this will lead to more business. And so it's probably particularly appropriate that this afternoon we have a diehard football fan as our first guest, and that's Paul Astengo for Finance Centre. So, Paul, thanks very much indeed for coming to talk to us. Fresh, I think, from Casemates, where you've been celebrating with everybody else the wonderful news about the UEFA news. What comments would you have for that?
Well, it's a fantastic day, isn't it, for Gibraltar, and well-deserved entry into UEFA. Team 54 have done a great job all the way through the process, so just one of the many people that are celebrating and no doubt continue to celebrate for days to come.
Excellent. Maybe weeks and months.
Hopefully.
Well, unfortunately, we're here to talk about other things other than football for a bit. We'll perhaps come back to that later. So, first of all, I guess, being a little bit presidential, the first 100 days in your new role. First of all, what's your title? Who do you work for? And what's the job all about?
Okay, that's a simple one to start with. I'm the Senior Finance Centre Executive. I am one of three people. Two are in situ already, and the third we're hoping will join us shortly. I look after the marketing drive that Gibraltar has outside of Gibraltar, naturally, looking to attract international business to Gibraltar. My particular area is the private client piece, which includes high net worth individuals, trust and company management, and also the banking sector as well.
So it's really an international role, most primarily. And I've heard about the BRICS initiative, the Brazil, Russia, India, China and South Africa. And that presumably is just one of the initiatives that you'll be looking at. Presumably going to look at other initiatives, but always international. Would that be fair?
International is where the business is, and that's what we're looking to attract into Gibraltar. Gibraltar, I think, has a fantastic proposition to offer across the globe, really. Our traditional markets, we won't forget those. The UK and Switzerland have served us very, very well. Mm-hmm. We're obviously a big player as far as the EU is concerned, and part of our marketing says that over and over again, so we're not going to forget that. But allied to that, we're always on the lookout for new markets that we can develop, particularly looking at, as you mentioned, the BRICS initiative. Mm-hmm. So in play now are Brazil, Russia, India, China and South Africa. And there are plans afoot over the coming months to start marketing quite aggressively in those territories, mm-hmm. looking to attract further business from them.
So I guess it's only 100 days, so it's a little bit early, but from an overall objective point of view, it's to build Gibraltar's brand across these countries and others, I guess, in cooperation with the private sector here in Gibraltar, in the areas that you've mentioned that are your particular responsibility.
That's right. Very, very important. I think the team ethic is extremely fundamental in what we're doing. We have to go and present a united front. There is a tremendous amount of good expertise within the professional firms in Gibraltar, mm-hmm. and that is a huge selling point. We'll be attending conferences, forums, seminars, as well as arranging our own trips to the territories that we've chosen, just to present Gibraltar's case over and over again.
Well, I guess over the last 100 days you've been disputing the fact that you're going to be living the life of Riley, running around to all these countries. I know from experience it's not always a bed of roses. But like me, before you're doing your present role, you were a banker of many years standing here in Gibraltar and indeed elsewhere. Mm-hmm. How different is the banking work? And do you think working in a bank as you did do in a number of different roles, do you think that set you in good stead for this type of role that will no doubt take in many countries, different cultures and so on? Has it been a good training ground, do you think?
No, absolutely. I mean, my background, as you quite rightly point out, is in banking. I worked in banks in Gibraltar, in the UK and also in Spain, and mostly has been in the international side as well. So it's given me exposure to a wide number of different nationalities and cultures. So the nuances of the different cultures, and that is something that I do understand. Mm-hmm. And that's fundamental and very, very important in what we're doing. We're going into other people's territories and we're being upfront with them and explaining to them why they should make Gibraltar their finance center of choice. So we need to understand them as much as anything else.
And I guess as just a final supplementary on this, I guess with the international pressure that we see every day building on centres such as ours for extra transparency and so on, which of course we can answer every time. I suppose that simply makes the challenge all the more interesting as you develop into the role internationally and so on, I guess.
I think it's in the Gibraltar psyche, isn't it? We've been attacked in many different ways over centuries now, and we have this inbuilt ability to look at issues, find a solution and push on forward. And I think that's that relentless drive forward that will keep on pushing the finance centre and other parts of the economy here in Gibraltar.
Which is a very nice link back to where we started, which is the football, which I happen to know is your abiding passion. But what makes up the real Paul Astengo when you're not working for the government and so on? What are your interests?
Well, football is a big part of my life. It
just
always
football.
Been. Just football, but in a wider sense, because my children also play football. So I spend a lot of time down at the Victoria Stadium cheering them on and participating with some fundraising activity and other stuff like that. So it's still the same sport, but at the same time, it's different angles to it.
And is it true, or is it just a wicked rumour that the children's names are in fact taken from footballers, or is that just a rumour?
Every single one, and it's absolutely true. Each have three first names, and each are related to the big passion in my life, other than my wife and children, of course, which is Manchester United.
I think that's a very good place to leave it. Paul Astengo, thanks very much indeed for speaking to us.
No problem.
All the very best of luck.
Thank you very much indeed.
Back
thank
to
you
the
for
office.
Inviting me.
Thank you. Well, thanks very much, Paul. Back to the office, he says. I suspect he'll be back celebrating the football very soon. Now for our second guest, and that's Graham Hampson. Now, people moving into Gibraltar need a lot of facilities, including office space, and sometimes it's tricky to find short-term space and all that goes with it. So I'm delighted to talk about the concept of easy office, and to discuss that with us today, as I say, is the director, Graham Hampson. So, Graham, thanks very much for coming to see us on this momentous football day. I suppose I've got to ask you before we start talking business, are you a great football fan as well?
To be honest, I'm not a great football fan, but obviously I recognise what a great momentous day it is actually for Gibraltar, for its fans and for all the people that live here.
I think we're all football fans today, aren't we?
I think we certainly are, yeah.
Great, great answer. I'm probably the same, actually. Well, thanks very much for coming in anyway on this important day. And you're a director of Easy Office, so I guess I've got to ask you straight off, what is the Easy Office concept? Perhaps you can tell us a little bit about the business and the type of facilities you offer.
Okay, basically we're trying to make the office solution as easy as we possibly can for the small business person. So the facilities obviously include walk through the door, tea, coffee, the basic things like a desk, somewhere to put your computer, network communication, and a telephone system as well. So as soon as you walk through the desk, you can basically sign up very, very quickly. We're looking at very small contracts, maybe 3 months, maybe 6 months. But we're trying to design the package around the actual individual person, business person, to try and make it as flexible and convenient as possible.
Well, that sounds very interesting. And can you give me some sort of typical profile? What would be, if there's such a thing, a typical type of user, a typical sort of client that you would expect to see?
Okay. The clients can vary, but we're probably looking for about three different people at the moment. Say if you're a business person within Gibraltar, maybe you work from home, but you'd like to be working in an office atmosphere just for maybe 15, 20 hours a month, something like that. You can drop into Easy Office and take care of your accountancy work. You know, part of the work that you don't really want to do in the home environment. Perhaps you're a company that's just starting on the way to becoming very famous and influential in Gibraltar. Looking around at the offices in Gibraltar, it's very hard to find leases for a very short period of time. So we designed a package for if you really wanted to start a business. It's a very simple and quick way to start one in Gibraltar and have your company name.
And at reasonable cost, I guess, you're bound to say.
A very reasonable cost, we believe.
Excellent. You're not Gibraltarian, though, yourself by birth, I guess. Perhaps you tell us, if you're not, where are you from and what brought you to Gibraltar in the first place?
Okay. I've actually been in Gibraltar for quite a few years now, 9 years it will be. Just about. We came over, well, I originally lived in a place called Wigan in the northwest of England. Prior to coming over here, myself and my business partner, Mike Fitzgerald, were based in Manchester with a business there. We obviously saw the great opportunity of coming to start a business in Gibraltar. Mm-hmm. Apart from the sunshine, there is, of course, all the great communications, the networks, and the fantastic social life you can have here.
Mm-hmm. That sounds good. Actually, 9 years is exactly the same time that I've been here, and so maybe for all Gibraltarians now, almost anyway, as close as we can be. Well, we've already established, haven't we, to wrap up, that you're not a football fan,
particularly. Mm-hmm. What makes the real Graham Hampson tick then? Are you fascinated by something else, or are your hands full with other things?
Well, so hands generally tend to be full nowadays with a very, very young family. Mm-hmm. I've got two daughters, and they tend to absorb all the hours, as I'm sure many families and many men find out. Apart from that, I obviously do dally in a few sports, a bit of mountain biking, a bit of tennis now and again. But it's all kind of very, very small hobbies at the moment.
Sounds like you have your hands pretty full. Well, the Easy Office concept sounds very good indeed and very interesting and rather unique here for Gibraltar by the sound of it. So we wish you all the very best, and no doubt we will perhaps come and speak to you again in due course and find out how it's going.
Okay.
For now, thanks very much indeed for coming to chat to us.
Thank you very much, Ian.
Well, thanks to Graham Hampson there. Very interesting and a rather unique concept, and tying in nicely with the development work that Paul Astengo, our first guest, was discussing. Put together, quite an interesting challenge for Gibraltar there. So, it's rather nice, isn't it, to be talking about football on this occasion and not the doom and gloom that I'm normally known for. And I think that's probably enough from me. Why don't we all go back to celebrating the football? So, thanks very much indeed for watching. See you next time. Bye-bye.